Mesh went. Irish heavies. The hardest heavies I've got. And then what we're going to do is, let's see here. 16 at Maplefield Mills, which is that one over there. So if I look at the map here, that's got to be, yeah, that's what I thought. Okay. That's got to be the train over here. That is way back over here. Let me on it! Excuse me. What I want to do is this one. Okay, so it's not that one. I want to reset that one. Okay. And then now we're going to enter it. Aha! And now what I want to do, what size tires are these? 580/70 R42. Cool. So these guys here, my 1455s, if I look, tractors, if I get in this bigger one, you guys can see I've done some off-camera work, and I'm up to $320,000, but we're gonna get some more money. We're gonna work on that and get some more, eventually. If I come look, where are they? Where are they? No, seriously. There, 1455 XL. They're 145. And if I look at what I want here, these, I was looking at this one, and all it requires is 85, but it's only a 4-bottom. That's going to take forever to plow my fields. I want these, but, you know, these require 400 horse tractors to pull them. Well, 240 and 300. This one requires 180. I think these will pull it. I just think it's going to pull it slower than this one. I think that's the only difference. So let's do it. Let's go ahead and buy it. and see what we got here. Dang.
Looking there.
This pulls it slower. Yeah, it's only pulling it at 6 miles an hour. Instead of like 8 or something. Prices. Are they still holding? 1632. Okay. Even though you cultivate them, they still want to. Wow. That'll increase your yield. So I'm gonna go ahead and fly. No, wrong button. Look at that one. It'll show that cultivated. And it should be fertilized. It don't show it, but it's fertilized. It's just plowed. Then it'll show cultivated. So cool stuff. This guy's almost done. We'll let him finish here, and I'll bring you guys back. Okay, guys, we're back. I'm gonna go ahead and drop off the cedar. let him go. That's so cool the way those work. Those plows work. They're, there's a name for them, and I can't think of what the name is for them. Rollover plow. That's what they are. Rollover plow, obviously. How do we look here? We're at 76%. Alright. I'll let you go. Be ready to get to you in just a minute. Alright, guys, so. Head stop the sprayer because, you know, he was running 7 miles an hour, the combine's running 6, and on top of that, you know, he's covering like a 30 foot swath. So I ended up having to stop him, and I went ahead and stopped the combine too, and I'll finish that myself, rather than wasting the hired help to finish, like, it's like pass and a half left, so I went ahead and I stopped them. Him on the cedar and go start drilling everything. Everything planted. And then eventually when I get enough money, go ahead and put this on. Where did I leave the drill? Let's get the drill down. I can't believe those says it requires 185 horse. The 140 horse tractor is pulling it. Right, if we look at these, which one did I buy? I bought that one, yeah, for $22,000. Says it requires 180. Now these I know it wouldn't pull. I know that. But that one says it requires 180. And my tractor is only 145? See, now that Ford, the Ford won't pull it. Because I think that, I don't know what the Ford is. It's this one here. That one's only 125. So I'm pretty sure that one won't pull it. But these are 145. 45 and that one was 25? 45, 25, yeah. So an extra 20 horse. I want this guy here. That's what I want. What were you? You're 409. I could get that one. Top speed 31, which, I mean, that really don't matter what the top speed is. I really want this one here. Quad track. I want it. That is my ultimate goal, is to get that one. I don't care about this one. That's 536. I don't care about that one. I want the quad track. Just because it's awesome. But yeah, we're going to get that one eventually. And then I want to upgrade to that plow. Which requires 300 horse. With that one, yeah, that was 9 miles an hour. And I'm only pulling it at 6. So that's the difference in the horsepower there. I would like a bigger seater. I've got that one. That requires 100. That one requires 180. That'd be nice. It'd be twice the cedar. But again, I want to save up because I want this guy here. 12, yeah, 15. I want that one. It requires 270. That's the one I want right there. That one requires 180. I could plant soybeans with it, but that's it. I can't do grass. This one I can do just about anything. What does that one show? That one shows those. Okay. It's only 140. I could technically get that one. That's 6. This one's 6. But this will do the grasses. That one won't do grass. That's just potatoes. Yeah, see, that'll do everything. Okay. Yeah, see, this can... That's only 8. Could be running 12, did it say? What was that one again? 9. So it's almost, and I think that's because he's going downhill. That he was able to pull it at 8. Guys, I'm going to sit here and let this guy finish combining. I might see if there's a small job to do on one of these other fields. And then once I get all the soybean off, we'll go dump it all into the train and go sell it and see what kind of money we can make. Alright guys, so we're going to end the episode here. I think. I got to look at the time. But we're going to dump this. I think we're probably out of time. make this one more short. My bow. And let's unload into the wagon. Hopefully there's enough room for it. There should be. Get the combine emptied out, and we'll park it inside. Yep, empty. Pull her in here and park it. Alright. Let's go get back in the truck. I'm pretty sure I don't have any grain stored. I'm almost certain I don't have any soybeans stored. Pretty sure I emptied it and I haven't put any back in. No. Okay. So let's go ahead and go get this dumped. Hit 3 to hit sense cruise control. I think once that guy over there is done cultivating, I'm gonna hook him on the sprayer and go spray that other field with a liquid fertilizer. Oh guys, watch this! Woohoo! Oh, that's so cool! Fly through the air truck. Oh, that's amazing. I love it. I love it. Tipped on that side. Oh well. Wrong side. Come on now. There we go. Alright, leave the truck for a minute. We'll go hop in the train. Ahead and hit cruise. No. I need to load up. I see a lot of soybeans. Car's 52% full. What are we still at? We're still at 1613. We were at 1632. So the price is going down, which sucks. But it's still a heck of a price. Because if you look, there's nothing else that's even remotely that price. So soybeans are still way to go. Bidding one, man. Bidding one. That's kind of cool that they make you use the train. And I can't unload there by train. I'm not gonna stop, am I? Nope. But not too bad. We didn't go too far fast. No, I didn't make it at all. Okay. I was thinking that was it back there, but this is actually the unloading spot here. Back up go. 101,000 in soybean sales. Crazy. That's crazy, dude. 101,000 in soybean sales. Wicked. That's wicked awesome. 101,000 in soybean sales. Love it. Love it. I love it. Helper J has completed their task. Okay. I'll be back at the dock here in just a second. And, but I think that's going to do it for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, hit that thumbs up button. Hit that thumbs up button for 101,000 in sales, man. Hit that thumbs up button for 101,000 in sales. That's a crazy amount of sales. Am I going to stop? Empty. Everything's empty. Alright. Let's take this deuter. I'm gonna go spray the other field. Alright guys, so that's gonna do it for today. Hit that thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.